God has blessed us with another beautiful day, so we have to continue learning. Yes, the three minor skills. Haven't you been asking about this? Here you are. The three minor skills. What is minor and what is major? From our previous lessons, we should know major scale by now. Any scale that follows the major rule, tone, tone, semitone, tone, 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 semitone, is a major scale. Yes, we should know major scale by now. Yes, any scale that follows the major rule, which is tone, tone, semitone, tone, 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 semitone, is a major scale. So we have two popular scales. It's either a major or a minor. Don't you agree with me? Any other scale which is not a major scale is a minor scale. I know the questions that are running through your brains now. What of the diminished scales? What of the augmented scales? What of the... If they are not major, they are minor. That's my conclusion. If the scale does not conform to tone, tone, semitone, tone, 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 semitone, then that is a minor. Yes. Anything other than what conforms to the major rule is a minor. So there are thousands of minor scales. Yes, there can be thousands. But for today, I'm only going to concentrate on three basic minor scales. On three most important minor scales, which are the natural minor, the harmonic minor, and the melodic minor. I know you might have heard about these three and you are yearning to learn them. Oh, I have a good news for you. By the time you are through with this, you have gotten the clear distinction between these three. Yes, this lesson is in three parts. With the first part, I'm going to try to give you a basic understanding of the minor systems in the first part. And I'll use simple chord structures and simple solos using the natural, the melodic, and the harmonic. Then in part two of this tutorial, I'm going to give you what we call influences. What other people, what other instrumentalists, what other guitarists, what other musicians have done with this minor system using basic and then some advanced chords. This is what I'll give you in the next lesson. We will be concentrating on a very beautiful song we call Sexteto Habanera. It is also an influence, a song by some Afro-Cuban group that you would want to play, I tell you. Then in the third chapter, that is my chapter, I'm going to give you what I am able to do with the minor system. What do I mean? This time, I'm going to try to mix minor with major chords and improvise on in a particular song I compose called Ghanaians in Spain. I'll teach you the melody and I'll teach you the improvisation techniques that I'll be using. Look, in case you haven't subscribed to my channel, this is the best time to do that. Yes, and tell your friend out there who is yearning to learn these days that the opportunity is here. George Sprouse is here to stay. I'm here to teach this time. Let me tell you something. In music, we use the first seven letters of the English alphabet, which is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A. When we get to G, we don't go to H, we come back to A. Yes. If we decide to assign numbers to these letters, then A will be our number one, B will be our number two. Is C not going to be our number three? Yes, it will. D will be our number four. E will be our number five. Did you notice what was number six? That was what? F. If we should calculate it well using tone, tone, semitone, it will end on F sharp. Therefore, the note which falls on our sixth degree in the A major scale is F sharp. So the relative minor for key A is F sharp minor. If I should break it a little bit further, this is how it should be. A to B is a tone. B to the next note, we need a tone. So Etum should take us to C sharp. From C sharp, we need a semitone to the next. Then from D, we need a tone, which is what? E. Between E and F, we have what we call natural semitone. But we're interested in a tone. So E will take us to F sharp. So we are going to have the interval between them. Tone, tone, semitone, tone, 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 semitone. Therefore, our C's degree from the root, which is A, is F sharp. So F sharp is our relative minor for key A. Is this not simple? Assuming we're building chords on this 7 that we have labeled, then we will be going to have chord 1, chord 2, chord 3, chord 4, chord 5, chord 6, chord 7. Because for every major or every standard chord sequence, or chord standard sequences, every chord 1, 4, 5 is a major, every chord 2, 3, 6 is a minor, and every chord 7 is a diminished chord. Please, let me repeat this. For every standard chord progression, every chord 1, 4, 5 is a major, every chord 2, 3, 6 is a minor, and every chord 7 is a diminished. We will be treating that later, not in this lesson. But today, take note that every chord 2, 3, 6 is a minor. And I don't want us to be using A because of the sharps, a lot of sharps. I want us to be using C, which we are very familiar with. There are no sharps and flats in there. So that will be very helpful. So if we should consider C as our parent scale, then the first degree is C, the second degree is what? D, the third degree is E, the fourth is F, the fifth is J, the sixth is A, that is our relative minor, and the seventh obviously will be B. So we are interested in the sixth, which is our relative minor. So it is three tones from the root, or three semitones behind a root. We are now thinking in key C. So our first chord will be a C major, based on the rules we just constructed. Then our first chord will be a C major, our second chord will be a D minor, our third chord will be an E minor, an F, our fourth will be an F major, our fifth will be a J or a J dominant seventh, our sixth will be an A minor. Our sixth, which is our relative minor, will be an A minor chord. And our seventh chord will be a B diminished seventh chord. If we should progress to the eighth chord, we are going to get the C again. So we will end on the seventh chord. And so with respect to key C, the chords that we are going to use is going to be... In order to be sure you really understand what I've just given you, I'm not going to even use key C. I'm going to play it in the key of J. Yes. What will be my degrees in the key of J? The first degree will be J, the second will be an A, the third will be what? B, the fourth will be what? C, the fifth will be what? D. And then the sixth, which is our relative minor in the key of J, is E minor. So this is our relative minor in the key of J. If we should continue, the next one, which is an F sharp, will be our seventh degree from J. So the chords that we'll be using for the main backing rhythm in this exercise will be first E minor. We can use play E minor to play E minor here. Or this, the moving E minor, they are all the same. Then we go to A minor. Then our third chord, a B minor. But because we'll be considering scales we call melodic and harmonic, we will usually change the B minor to a B dominant seventh to make the chord more pleasing to our ears. We can leave it at B minor, but I prefer we change the chord from a B minor to a B dominant seventh. Why? Because of the scales I'm going to teach you. So, and at the top registers, this is how it will sound like. Progression we'll be doing our lectures on. And somewhere along the line, when I'm teaching, I'll play it on a different, on the same, with the same tempo, but we will change the style of playing a little, and you see how the improvisation also will change. So, this is the point I'm trying to make here. With respect to key C, the C's note is A. So if we should start on A, then we are going to get our first minor scale we called the natural minor. Now we are thinking in the key of G. Yes, we are in the key of G. And we are going to get our scales between the 7th and then the 10th fret position. The sixth note from G will be what? Will be an E. An E. So if you play 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The sixth note is an E. And you prefer starting from the lower E, the octave. So if we start from E and we follow the same scale and we follow the same C major rule, then we are getting our A natural minor. So La, Do, Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La. La, Do, Do. La, Ti, Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La. So that's our very first minor scale, the natural minor in the key of G. I just want to make sure you really understood this lesson. And that would be an E natural minor. La, Ti, Do, Re, Fa, Sol, La. Once you've gotten the natural minor, then the other two are so simple. It is just an alteration of the sixth degree and then the seventh degree. Your La becomes your root. So the La becomes your first degree. So 1, La, Ti, 2, Do, 3, Re, 4. Mi, 5. This is it. This is so simple. First one is La, Ti, Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La. When we alter it, the harmonic minor will be. I also sing along so that you can follow. And when I finish, I expect you to spread it across the board. La, Ti, Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Si, La. Mm-hmm. La, ti, do, re, mi, fa, si, si, la. And then the melodic minor will be very simple. La, ti, do, re, mi. Watch. Fi, fi, la, mi, fi, fi, la, melodic, mi, fi, fi, very simple, la, ti, do, re, mi, fi, fi, going to try to use them on a backing track. Try to see if you can identify them. Remember, this is in three parts. Lesson two, lesson three. Please enjoy this beautiful improvisation.